I got time to do this? Hi.
Hi.
Hi. How are you feeling, Mr. Ray? Late night?
Late night? Good night? Did you have a good time?
Did you?
Yeah. Yeah.
Did you try to sing?
Did you sing? Yeah. I didn't know the words.
Were you surprised by how eagerly they joined in the singing?
Well, the whole party joined in the singing. And evidently, it's a very well-known Russian song. I thought Van Cliburn was just great. First time in 9 years that he's played. I mean, really, it's...
What did you and she talk about last night? Did you have a chance to...
She was with my husband.
Well, did you ask your husband what they
talked about with Mr. Gorbachev?
We talked about our coming to Moscow.
Where? Did you set a date?
No, I really leave that to other people.
Is it definitely you will be going?
I don't know.
Did he have an itinerary for you when you arrived there? Tell you what you should see?
No. Well, he thought I should see the Kremlin. I said I'd like to see Leningrad and L'Hermitage. Then we told that story I told you. Then we got into a lot of discussions with Dick Cheney and Richard Pearl. It was a very
did he seem to be having
lively
a good
conversation.
Did he seem to be having a good time? Did he laugh a lot? Did he?
No. He did. No, he's very easy.
Do they seem a little jet lagged or having any trouble?
Not at all. No, not at all. Maybe they are, but they didn't seem it.
Now that you've had a chance to see Mrs. Gorbachev a little more, what can you do? Had a chance to talk to her a little bit more than you've had in the past?
Yeah, you know, the only time I've had to see her really is the coffee that you have after the state arrival that you do with every visitor. And then there are a lot of people there, and when you're going through translators, it makes it difficult.
Mrs. Reagan, can you share with us some of the things that you spoke with Mrs. Gorbachev about?
At the coffee?
Yes.
That makes it seem so long ago now. We talked about she was talking about the Soviet Union,
did she ask any questions about America?
No.
What do you plan to talk about today? What do you think you might be talking about today?
I will see.
Mrs. Reagan, there's been much made of a competition between you two on clothes, on
so silly.
All sort of areas.
So silly. I mean, this is a summit of pretty substantive issues, you know. That's what I felt the same way in Geneva. That's not right.
What did you and she talk about that being silly, or did she say?
No, but I assume she feels that way.
Mrs. Reagan, yesterday at the signing, you suggested to her you shake hands, and both of you did. Mm-hmm. Could you tell us what prompted you to make the suggestion that you shake hands?
Well, our husbands had shaken hands, and so I thought we should shake hands.
Mrs. Reagan, excuse me, I'm from Soviet school. I've seen you yesterday dancing with your president. Did the Gorbachev join you dancing?
No, they had gone home.
Thank you. Well, Mrs. Reagan, is there any ill feeling between you and Mrs. Gorbachev? It seems like it's not great.
But you all are, no, I'm not making any ill feelings.
Okay, I was just basing it on Larry Speaks' book.
Well, I didn't read it that way, and Larry Speaks is not me.
Is there anything in particular that you'd like to show her here at the White House? Anything
that means? Oh, well, everything that we're going to be saying.
Any particular piece of art or room that means something to you that you'd like to share with her?
Well, there's a mantelpiece in the state dining room that I think is, which has a little inscription on it that I think is nice. eyes.
What's the inscription?
I'm not going to tell you. You have to wait and find out.
Mrs. Reagan, one last question. Looks like Mrs. Gorbachev is actually speaking English. Have you noticed that she's actually learned English since you last met her? Have you been able to talk to her in English at all?
No.
Tell us your impressions of Mrs. Gorbachev.
She's very, very nice, very bright, intelligent. I think I better go and meet her, or else she's not going to be very thrilled.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you.
Intelligent.
Quite subtle. Sometimes it's not quite. It must be tough.
Good morning.
This picture that we face, to what century does this belong? I would say that this is a typical picture of the 20th century.
Right. Right. Right.
Andrew White's exhibition was held in Moscow, as I said.
Yes, I know.
I'm sorry.
Okay, let's take it very.
Connected in any way with the life and functioning or present tense?
No, it wasn't. You have this.
I hope they do use the blue screen.
The White House deal.
It was built between 1702 and 1800, the first president of the United States.
Who was the first president of the United States? John Adams.
John Adams.
Это был первый президент, который приехал и жил в Белом доме. Вашингтон did not live here.
Нет, не жили, да?
Вашингтон, Линкольн жил.
А, Линкольн жил, да? А Вашингтон
А Эдамс был первым американским президентом, который приехал в Белом доме.
Когда и Джефферсон
жил. Джефферсон тоже жил.
Джефферсон тоже жил.
Здесь был его кабинет. Да?
Вот в этом.
В этом, да.
В этом.
И Джексон тоже здесь. И Джексон тоже пользовался
этим. А Линкольн не была.
Но архитектор все же предусматривал, что здесь была столовая.
С самого начала
And the chandelier, what, does it also belong to the 19th century?
Here,
It's an official residence, it's an official house.
Я думаю, по-человечески, хочется жить в доме, в обыкновенном доме. А это официально учреждение.
I would say that, humanly speaking, a human being would like to live in a regular home.
Сейчас то, что госпожа Рейган мне рассказывает, это история Америки.
And Mrs. Reagan is kind enough to tell me what she does about the history of America.
Это музей истории Америки.
And indeed, this house is a museum of the history of America.
Здесь художественные экспонаты.
I see that there are beautiful paintings here. Yes, very good art.
I want to show you something I really like.
Yeah,
this was a saying that was put on here, taken from a letter John Adams wrote his wife. Says, I pray heaven to bestow best of blessings on this house and all the children hereafter inhabited, and none but honest and wise men ever rule over the world. A friend of us, how is it?
Хорошее письмо.
Very good letter.
Пусть честные и мудрые люди говорят. Хорошие слова президента.
Indeed, only the honest and the wise should rule the world.
Пусть
Very good words.
Так, честные и мудрые люди правят этим.
Very good words.
А я
хорошо, что я просто не сам говорю, что Рузвельт приказал.
Вы знаете ансамбль Ленинграда? Сколько там красивых тоже исторических мест.
I invite you to come to Leningrad and to come to Moscow because you know how rich those two cities are in architectural ensembles. We have many historic sites there, great historic buildings there.
Это наша история, это ваша история.
But that is our history. This is your history.
Mrs. Gorbachev, you have a chance to meet with average people during your trip to the United States.
У вас будет возможность встретиться с обычными американцами в вашем городе в Америке. I would say that meeting people is the most interesting thing. Even more so that I never doubt and I am confident of the sincere, honest and friendly feelings of the Americans, of the American people.
Ну, я считаю и вас, и себя тоже людьми, с которыми мы контактируемся.
But I consider myself and I consider you
встреча
to be those
с вами
people
это тоже для меня встреча с американцами.
So meeting you for me is meeting Americans.
А на сей раз наш визит очень... Я просто надеюсь, что в следующий раз будет больше.
This time our visit is too short. I hope next time it will be longer.
This is the room where most of the first ladies love to have their meetings, their social functions and so on. Студия Никитина.
Regrettably, however, I don't have time to specially study the history of the United States.
Regrettably, I don't have time.
You know that in our century, in our age, we all of us have to work. And we have professional duties. We have our family duties. As well as social duties.
И человек 20 века не знает, как распределить свои силы.
And a person living in the 20th century is at a loss as to how to distribute his or her strengths and time, although we, all of us, seek to know as much more as possible.
Thank you.
state of the city.